Welcome back, Random TV Reviews, your girl Lynette.
And it's your boy, Stanley.
Alright, coming in for Empire this week. I'm gonna be honest with you right out the gate. I was trying to figure out
What the hell was going on? Cause they was...
What did I watch?
Yeah, it was kinda like all over the place.
And Lee Dames, let me go ahead and get you together real quick. See, now you're doing some Tyler Perry skit, where it seems like you're taking our loyalty and our time for granted. This just came back on from, was it mid-season break?
Yeah, mid-season break.
And we're already having filler episodes?
Nah,
I don't have time.
Yeah, we don't need none of that. We need you to get straight to the point.
Yeah, we watched this last night. We almost did a review last night, and I said, maybe I need to marinate on it some more. Maybe some things will come together. And skit came together. So...
Only one thing to me made sense. We'll talk about it when we get there.
Okay, so it's called Shift to Save Your Life for all the new subscribers. Welcome. If you are OG, welcome back. Y'all know how y'all do. Just sit back, relax, and we go try to give it to you. And at the end of it, we hope that all roads lead to Ford Motor Company. If they don't, just get dropped off over there at Chevrolet.
Yeah.
So, y'all know last week the defense had picked up Thurston, right? And when they got him back there, they were basically telling him, look, we know that you have a connection with Lulu and Damon Cross. So basically, we've been watching them for a while. We're going to take these two down. You can go down with them if you don't tell us what we need to know and help save yourself, or it's a wrap for you. So give us what we need, help yourself, we can work out a deal. Or go down with your loyalty, and it be the end of Thurston. So Thurston basically, and I said, I know Thurston was not going to go down.
Yeah, like he wasn't going to rat them out. I don't care how much pressure you apply to him. He wasn't going to turn off.
I was scared for a minute, though.
He would turn himself in first before he turned in Lucius and Damon Cross.
So we did get filled in a little bit of how Damon Cross came into the picture. And what had happened was, remember that time when Lulu then went broke for like the 30th time?
Yeah.
He couldn't afford to pay Thurston anymore. So he told Thurston, like, basically, I can't have you around working as my lawyer because I'm not able to pay you. Yeah. And I know that you work off of the loyalty system and the loyalty code and you that, but I can't do that to you, bro. So I'm going to go ahead and release you. You go out there, you do some more work, and I will pay you back your money. And then we do it like that. So, Thurston was at the party where Lucius was at, and Damon Cross ended up being at the party.
Said a ram in the bush.
Yeah. Now, Thurston had this girlfriend that he was real sweet on, and that she ended up leaving her job to be kind of like his co-pilot. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and it started a new business.
And starting a new business. So, right off the bat, when Damon Cross came into the picture, old girl was like, Thirsty, nah. Don't work with him. Don't take him on as a client.
This dude right here, he dangerous.
And Thirsty's whole thing was, if I can handle the skit that I don't see Lulu do,
oh, Damon Cross ain't nothing.
And she was like, I'm trying to tell you, do not work with old boy. Well, he ended up doing just that.
Yeah,
so that's how we ended up with old Damon Cross in the picture and come.
Yeah, because we thought he just showed up at the poker table. So I do appreciate you filling in that, you know.
So now we know how he got the picture. We know how all of this went down. And we knew that he was grimy. But I still don't think he is as grimy as Lulu is, to be honest with you.
The only thing he did different that Lulu have not done, if they lose, they all lose. So in this case, when Damon Cross lost the $250,000 at the poker table, now all of a sudden he won Thurston to bring the money back. That ain't how it worked, pimp.
You lost.
If you lose, I lose, we all lose. We just have to recoup it. I ain't got to pay you the money back.
Yeah.
So, yeah. So, that's the only difference that I saw so far. I don't see him comparing to Lucius.
So, while Thurston is running all this down to the feds of how he knew both of these people, that's how we got filled in. And then he turned it all around. Because I said, you really going to rat all of them out and tell all they business?
Yeah, because she had them back in the corner, had the phone records, the text messages,
the bank records, the
picture of the picture that belongs to Cookie. So I was like, honey, yeah, you can get out of that one Thursday. But I said, I know he gonna do it because he can talk his way out of a wet paper bag, Mike.
And that's exactly what it did. He was like, you know what? Let me go ahead and give it to you straight. That girl that I said that I was dating, I basically was a broke lawyer, didn't have nothing. Wanted to stick my chest out and act like I was playing with in the big leagues. So I put myself in the presence of these great men that had great influence and had power. And that's how I know both of them. So we were rubbing shoulders, but it isn't what it looks like. Basically, Thurston, he took them around the corner of buck you, have a good life. Uh-huh. And he walked up out of there just like Justin did.
Put his Coming to America coat on.
It was out.
I was out the door.
And I said, okay, I can appreciate that. So another thing that happened, like I'm not even going scene by scene because I don't know what the hell I watch.
Yeah.
I can't appreciate what Lee Daniels did where he squashed the beef between Treasure and Tiana.
Tiana, yeah.
And basically he was like, listen, Jamal had them sitting down, was like, what's y'all beef with each other?
Yeah, what's
and
the real beef?
And come to find out that they're both playing into the hands that the men over top of them have, that have groomed them to act like this, mm-hmm. so that they can take positions and songs and all of this from other people. And Jamal was like, y'all don't even have to do that.
Nah.
But y'all don't condition yourselves and been brainwashed so
much by these men
to act like this that y'all can't even get along to do a collab because you're still trying to fight each other for a position that both of you all have.
Yeah. It don't make any sense.
And they both were like, we feel real stupid right now.
Uh-huh.
And they got together and they did the song. And I was like, okay.
But so I appreciate, like you said, that he spoke to our black women that if y'all work together,
do anything.
Man, you can do anything, accomplish. Look how good they sound when they came together, man.
I mean, matter of fact,
they blended together. I couldn't even tell which one was
them. I was going to say they were singing
so good. So let's not be in competition, but come together and take our position back and do some great things, man.
Yeah. So over there at Empire, we're still trying to figure out what's going to be the big moment to get Empire back on the map. And of course, they're saying, you know what, we need to take our artists out on tour, but we ain't got no money for that. And Giselle was like, you know what? No, we can't do it. We can't risk it. The reward is not going to outweigh the risk of this if it goes south. And y'all may have each other, but this is all I have. Y'all not going to play with my paycheck.
But Cookie was like, we putting it all on the line too. But so really, the more risk is on Cookie them because they got a family.
But what she was saying was, the Lions are powerful. Y'all can rebuild. I can't do skit right
now. Okay, I got you.
So, I got what she was saying. Eventually, through some talking and all that, Lulu came up with the bright idea of, let's do a trust tour.
Yeah.
And a trust tour was going to be for free. And it was going to gain the trust of, because that was the whole thing was,
gain the Empire trust back. Yeah,
their trust with their folk was garbage. So yeah. Now we got to regain the trust. So we're gonna have a trust tour. They're gonna start it off in Philly. And they're gonna go around, and they will recoup their money. Cause like I told Stanley, I said, when you go to free events, you spend more money than if you actually paid to be there for some strange reason. Go to a free event and see how much money you spend.
Yeah, you're gonna buy all the food, you're gonna buy souvenirs, you're gonna buy t-shirts.
You can do everything.
Yeah, you can do everything because you feel like I've saved a lot of money because I ain't had to pay for the event.
Yeah.
And then they're gonna turn around and gonna end up buying the music because they're gonna like some of the music that they hear.
Yeah.
So even if they don't buy the music, they're gonna go back and listen to it on Google Play, Apple Tunes, and every time you listen to that music, they making money.
They're gonna get some money. And then Lucius told the artist, you know, don't worry about the fact of, you know, what your salary. We're guaranteeing that you're still going to get your same salary. So don't worry about it. Because they was like, hold on, we're not doing, just because y'all tried to gain trust.
But I'm like, what is y'all paying them salary with? You can't.
Yeah.
Giselle said y'all couldn't afford to do the tour, but you're still paying everybody to sing for free.
In my mic be voice, don't even worry about it. It don't even matter.
But I appreciate them taking a risk because they, at this point, they have no choice. Mm-hmm. They can't play it safe. They too dead in the water, man.
Yeah.
They have to take a risk.
But I do see the silver lining. You know, before we went on break, Cookie was doing a whole lot of like Instagram lives, Facebook lives, and basically showing the real of the real. and giving people a piece of her that they hadn't been able to get before. And she had caught the eye of this agent from LA. And the agent was like, listen, I want to meet with you. I want to turn you into a brand, blah, blah, blah. Mm-hmm. Cookie wasn't feeling it at first. So old girl, she got flued in.
Oh,
she got flued in. And Cookie was able to sit down and talk to her. And the girl was like, listen, Cookie, you are a brand within yourself.
True.
Whether you know it or not.
True.
You could be the next Oprah. You could be the next Beyonce. Mm-hmm. Your name is a brand.
Yeah.
And Cookie was like, you know, I ain't really got time for this.
I'm like, stop blowing smoke up my A.
Yeah, she was like, my brand is here. I'm trying to rebuild empire. And basically the girl was like, this brand that you have right here, right now, this can be the stepping stone for empire to get off the ground, because you already have the powerful and positive influence on your audience right now.
Yeah.
So that's what got Cookie like, So I believe with her linking up with this agent is actually going to help Empire as well. Because I don't see any other way.
And then she said she's going to be on The View. I was like, on The View?
She said you can take Whoopi's back when Whoopi go on vacation.
I was like, what? That's what Cookie was like. I know you bulls get to me now. I might be bad, but I ain't that bad, though.
And homegirl said, try me. Check my resume, basically.
But old Lee Daniels was throwing a nugget out there to us. Don't just sell products and services. Become a brand.
Become a brand.
Because people forget about stuff that they bought, but people never forget a brand.
Mm-hmm.
Like, y'all would never forget us.
Nah. And we ain't even a brand, but
we're working on it, though.
Last thing I'm going to hit on is Andre.
Oh, man.
See, they are trying to trick us. I promise you.
Nah, yeah. It's smoke and mirrors right now, man.
If they put Andre in the casket, this will be the laziest writing that I've ever seen in my life.
That's too easy, man.
It's
too easy.
Well, Andre, remember last week, he got a call from the doctor. The doctor was like, I need to see you. Well, he ended up having a CT scan. Andre has stage 4 cancer.
I don't believe it.
So the first thing that I said was, do Ms. Dubois got something to do with this?
Mm-hmm.
That's because exactly you know that she always tampers with Andre in the realm of the medical realm.
Yeah, she's still trying to take them boys down. We ain't seen them, but she's still working behind the scenes.
So I'm like, who is this physician? And where did he come from? And now all of a sudden, Andre went from a bloody nose down all the way to stage 4 cancer.
Mm-hmm.
So he goes and he tells Terry that he has cancer and gave her basically sign off on this and you will inherit my life.
Yeah. So you and Wichita will be
y'all
straight.
Y'all will be good.
Yeah.
And she was like, what? And how long did they say you had to live? And he was like, a couple of months.
Yeah, months.
And she was wait a minute, Andre.
So this ain't no.
So you just gonna give up like that?
She was like, ain't no way. You came into our life for nothing. The Lord brought you here for a purpose.
And now you made it 10 months.
And then it's like this?
I don't want your money.
Yeah, I want you.
She ended up bringing him the documents back and she said, if I sign these, it is basically as if I've given up on you.
Mm-hmm.
And she said, no. What we going to do with your knowledge and my will, we're going to fight this thing. And we're going to fight this thing together. Because nothing's going to happen to you, Andre.
But you know
Andre broke down.
Yeah, but you know what's so funny, though? Is that somebody can be walking around with cancer, go to the doctor, and the doctor tell them that they got cancer.
And go straight
down. And they start going down because at that point, they start believing that they got cancer. So it's almost like if you don't know, you good.
Yeah.
Kinda.
The Bible said, whatsoever a man thinketh,
so is he.
So you better be careful what you believe.
So the doctor say one thing, you be like, nah, doc, I understand that you got your physician's license with the school, forget all this, but hey, I ain't got no cancer, Mike.
No, I wouldn't even take it that far, because I would accept your diagnosis, but I'm not going to die.
That's
right. Because I'm going to do everything that I know to do.
I'm going
to
be it.
I'm going to go back to my ancestors and how they cured themselves over and over and over again. And I'm going to figure out what is the formula for my DNA that's going to
break my mind here. And matter of fact, I'm healed right now.
Yeah. So, because I hate when people
I claim my healing.
I hate when people go to the doctor first of all, you go to the doctor so they can tell you what's wrong with you. Then when they tell you what's wrong with you, I rebuke that in the name of Jesus.
Yeah, don't do all that. Yeah, don't do all that.
What the hell you go to them for? You go to them so that they can tell you what's going on so that you can go back and you can be an instrument in your own healing along with them. But don't go in there with the devil's a lie.
Yep. It's a good opportunity to become a conduit for God's miracles.
Yeah.
So that doctor can see that God is powerful, that even though you made the diagnosis, God got the final say.
But anyway, so, I don't know if we ended up at Ford Motor Company, so if not, get off at Chevrolet.
Look here, before we exit stage left, Lee Daniels, you better give it to us next week, man.
Yeah, because I can't.
We ain't got time. We, you know, we busy.
Real busy. I could be doing anything else.
Say, don't disrespect my time. Put some respect on my time.
Or pay me.
Yeah.
Straight from the VA.
The dirty, dirty South.
Two up, two down.
Holla.